The reason I came to the US to present in the Global Symposium on health, which is a little strange for me to link to the health sort of network. But I think it's so interesting to link with the different field. And many of my experience, people from the health sector, they are more sensible. But people in the housing sector, sometimes they're not very sensible. We tend to be too conventional, too traditional. And this day we drive by the market and we think housing is something, you know, a kind of a market production. And we lost the sense of social. We build the whole system of human being, the whole society, the whole community, through the housing process. But today we sort of totally losing that kind of concept. We are more on the kind of economic generation and buy and sell, and sort of everybody live in a big apartment or big condominium, but live so isolation from each other. We don't build any social relationship and so on. So I was a little unhappy with our own profession. Therefore, when the health professional group would like me to make a presentation, I think it's a really interesting idea and see how we make this relationship also. Also, is a way to expand the knowledge and the linkage between different fields. Yeah. So this is on impact of urban housing development on health. But of course, I take many of the experience from the work that I think is very important on building communities and what would be the answer for that. So this is the picture of urban poor housing, not in Thailand, but in different parts of Asia. This probably be Bangladesh, I think, or the Philippines. This probably not in Kenya, could be in India, and this could be in Cambodia. This could be somewhere in Central Asia. But this picture show that the insecure and poor housing condition cause problems of quality of life and health to big number of poor people in the unhealthy social and physical environment living conditions. So you talk about health, and you look into the housing condition, definitely you see the very poor housing condition would cause a lot of health problems. And if we are health manager, we should care that housing should be one of the very important subjects to deal with health in a big way. It's sort of correlated, it's sort of closely linked between the two. These are all the conditions of low income housing area where services are bad. You can imagine what are the health issues of them. This one to say that city needs people and labors, but we do not provide sufficient affordable housing for them. So they find any possible room to live anywhere. Yeah. And either it's healthy or unhealthy, that's not a priority. Only a room to survive, a room to build houses. Legal or illegal is also not an issue. So this is the situation of the scarcity of the housing conditions make a very unhealthy living condition to a big number of poor people. Some city, maybe more than 10%, some city more than 20%, some city may go up to 30-40% or up to 50%. No? You may see that poor people living area like this is not really many, but it has a lot of people. And this is the important chart I showed them. I said, problems of housing, which impact on health? So each mosaic is the reason, the cause and the reason leading to health issues. So you have stressful life, psychological problems with insecurity, debt, fear, and rise. you have sexual problems and you have young mothers, you have unsafe living environment, you have violence, you have bribery, you have crimes, you have you live in no space, so you don't have any space to exercise for children or for whatever. You have drug addicts, and many of the poor people earlier are the place where they even sell drugs informally. Yeah, it's a market. Yeah. So the poverty, that unhealthy environment cause nutritional disadvantage and sickness. Insecure senior tenure leading to no improvement, eviction, and even fire. Insecure house open to rats, mosquito, insects, and many other disease. When you talk about health issue, and we look into these different kinds of housing, you know, the low-income housing, we face all these kind of health issues in a multiple health problems spring up from this bad living condition. What we try to tell the health community, and maybe many of us here also, is that health doesn't come by itself. So if we want to make it better, if we want to solve the problem, the problems are integrated. It's not only physical problems. So you have inadequate income, you have illegal housing, built on rented, which is overcrowding. You don't have sufficient services. You have to pay for high transport, and you face eviction. You are outside of the political system. You're voiceless. You have no protection from law. You have worked in the informal economy. Not only you have very low income, but you face different kinds of harassment. Then the overcrowding and inadequate services cause large disease and injury burden. And that's why the poor people pay a higher cost for housing service and healthcare. Income loss to illness. So poverty exacerbated, income reduced. When I used to work with the poorest family, we were trying to support housing for the poorest family. And we let community people search for whoever the poorest in this community. So we provide support for housing. I would say about 80% or 90% of the families selected by the poor people in the community for the poorest of the poor. In that family, they always have somebody sick. Either the key person in the family sick and they cannot work properly, or the wife sick, or the children sick, or one of the people in the family always sick. And that caused the reduce in the income. Yeah. So it means any family who have sickness, they're destined to be poorer than the other. So poverty and sickness go together. Therefore, they have more multiple legal and health issues. Yeah. But why housing is important? Why? Why housing is important? Because housing is a basic need. In Buddhism, we say this is one of the four basic needs for human life. Yeah. It renew energy. It's a space for our freedom. It's the place that we link and make a community. Secure housing provides people and families secure with acceptable status. It makes people legal or illegal. If you are in the legal area, it means your life is legal. Yeah. So housing is a factor or a subject determine whether the family is in illegal or not, or informal or not. Yeah. So either they are citizens of the city, they're entitled to the service of the city or not. That's quite important. And insecure housing causes unhealthy living condition, infrastructure problem, higher expense, eviction, threat, insecure life, stress, you name it. No? So this is why housing is the core of health issue. This is what I'm selling to the health community, that secure housing is a key subject to deal with health issue, especially in the low-income communities. Because these people normally don't have a proper house legislation. But the important thing is more than that. Not only that. The important thing is in the red color. I'm trying to say that, do we have secure housing and strong community to function as an immune system and social vaccine to develop and protect all the members? This is the key point of the presentation. Proper housing or secure housing is not the only answer. But it is important that we need to have a system of people. Huh? We need a good system of people. So the system of people or the organization or strong community, it becomes an immune system. It helps protect each other. It's a social vaccine. I'm trying to put in word. Yeah. That's more than physical. Yeah. And that is something missing in our society. We have this kind of housing and we think that this could, okay, be the solution, the private sector or the public sector housing. Many of this kind of housing is better than not doing, okay? Better than not doing. But it's not enough. This kind of public sector housing or private sector housing in the market, it provides mainly the physical setting. People live in isolation from each other. You don't have an immune system, what we're trying to say. Yeah? Why only focus on physical change? It's not enough. Physical change is not enough. Why not making housing an important process to build communities and people? If we have housing as a process to build the system of people, yeah, we can find a way how the demand-driven housing development approach to so many integrated problems and build community at the same time could be an important thing to deal with. And this is the real immune system. Yeah. Yeah. Immune system doesn't come because everybody live in isolation from each other. But that is a system that we protect each other, we help each other, we care for each other. And then we can deal with health in a more holistic way. Yeah. So this is the issue. So conventional housing approach only housing units for affordable buyers. Is not the solution. And actually, poor people cannot reach them anyway. Poor people cannot reach them anyway. So we need a new change of approach. We need a new change of approach that we should try people approach. Start where people are. Instead of we build something, do something, and people live without knowing each other, we should start where they are. And build a system that they build housing for themselves as much as possible. Try people approach, start where people are, make people the key subject of making change. The world has changed. Changed in the wrong way. I just try to bring back that the world to change in such a way that we look at these people as a subject. Yeah. So let people be the active actor to make change, to secure housing and build strong, healthy communities and people for the cities. And this is the way we deal with the healthy issue in a more holistic manner. Otherwise, you have the expert in the Heliford Foundation where they have a global health issue in so many countries in the world. So they have a lot of expert on public health, expert on mother and child, expert on different things. Yeah, you name it. Because medical science is very large. So you have different pockets of expertise. But you're not going to solve the problem of health in a big way, except we look at health issues from the people and let them be capable of dealing with health by themselves as much as possible and link with the other expertise. in order to make the system lean and cover everybody. Yeah? So I'm sort of trying to show how it is possible. Back to the Thai citywide upgrading, where we start from people and let the people be an active actor, yeah, to develop housing. And this housing is not only housing, it includes health at the same time. And I think many of you remember that this model is a model where we start from the people, we survey, and then we let the people find a solution. So this is the process where people in the whole city, municipality, look into all the existing area, or no matter how scattered it is, and find the different housing solution. And not only housing, it's also all the social system allow that. So this is the kind of mapping that we have to do for all the urban poor area in any given city. Yeah. And from that, you start from that and then trying to see what are all the solution possible. The key is to let the people do it. And this could be a little difficult for researcher, like people in the BRI, but sometimes we have the world of the researcher in which we are the one who use a lot of technology. And then we identify the area without people involved. But a very good thing, in my suggestion, is that let the people on the ground be active and do it with the researcher. And do the saving, which means you build up capacity for finance, financial capacity at the same time. You heard about it, so I'm not going to elaborate on that. Yeah? And the key issue is, we just make finance flexible and available to all these groups who want to make change. This is what the world is not trying to work sufficiently. Yeah? Make finance easy. Make finance easy and let the people in whatever circumstances get together and organize, and then we pass the finance to them. And we make different kinds of plan that suitable to the group of people, yeah? You pass the funding, this is the co-op, and the co-op can have different subgroup. You pass it 4%, you give it to the member at 6%, you have 2% margin. And this 2% margin would allow all the slow payment, all the development possible. Really simple, but it works. Until now in Asia, I couldn't find the system. I'm sorry to say. Maybe the work is a failure. Really try to promote it to so many governments. And I feel the government in Asia don't have a problem with money. They're quite rich. In fast growing urban development everywhere. Economy is sort of moving up. They have the money, but they don't believe in this. People themselves can be the same as the private sector to find their own solution. They still want only the private sector, the rich one, to do the redevelopment and determine what should be the way of living for everybody. The public sector housing is gone, except in China. India doesn't go very effectively. So private sector is become the solution. Why not let the people doing similar to the private sector, but build the social system at the same time? So you send architects, planner, to work with the people on how to plan, how to make change, how to make the living condition better. And it's a lot of fun to do that. And you have the project like this I showed before, like this slum here, and you change to something like this. This is a re-blocking, reconstruction of the canal, block by block. We have new picture to show you. Nobody, no, you can also make an open space inside and it change into a more healthy condition. This is what happened now, allow 3,000 families along the canal have reconstructed the housing along the canal, different kinds of housing compared to this. The picture tells itself this is very unhealthy, very unorganized. So these are the existing people. You move them from the canal and you reconstruct it. So it has more density, but it's possible. And people do it, to the contractor or some part, they do it all by themselves. Or you do it like this, you break all this and they reconstruct like this. This is per unit. They take only about $8,000. $8,000 per one unit. Repair 15 years. So per month is only $70. $70. I just quickly think of my train ticket one way. $180 for instance. So expensive. But repairment about $70 per month. No? So it is very simple and possible. But they have also the community organization. The area need to be redeveloped. The different slum can move into whatever available land. And you get together and you build a strong community where you have different sections of former communities. So it's not the physical. Physical is something easy to understand, not so easy for some, but not too difficult. But when we lay down the system of people in the area, how to do it in such a way that this all this people system here is organized, a way to develop many social aspects, many social economic things together. Or you move from here to there, same group. This is the house renter. Scatter all over the area like that, and they purchase the land, they build this housing. They pay cheaper than when they was a renter. So to make house affordable is not a problem. It's not a great problem. Only how we organize it. But if we don't find an alternative way and we only look to the market as the only solution, it's very difficult. These people are totally out of that system. So active people participation in the process, if they work together, they build community together. And if they do it together, the cost for construction will be less. And we found that it's about half compared to the contractor housing. If they build all by themselves, it's cheaper. And you have the canal clean up, you have the house along the canal, you let the people take care of the canal. The municipality is not going to clean this that regularly. But people who live along the canal can do that. You can make a system in which all the water, wastewater to go to the canal could be cleaned up with treatment, whatever. And you can get the youth people to be an active actors. With the saving group that organize community can set up a community fund. And with the community fund, it's like a bank. And with this bank, they can develop similar program, welfare activities, income generation. They can help each other when affected by disaster. So this is something more than physical setting. And this is important one. There are similar places where the elderly people, they get together and they have the elderly club. They have a dancing club, you know, all elderly people. So instead of we take care of the elderly people like, you know, the group of people who are not able, who need too much care. You let the elderly people have fun. And when they get together, they're very lively. And then you let them sing whatever kind of program they want to do together. Exercise, have a trip, you know, or do the cleanery. Go somewhere or make a club. A dancing club, this is a dancing club. When they have the event, the elderly people are ready, dressed in a very nice dress, and they get the young people to pay for the elderly to dance. Whatever, doesn't matter much. But they're very active and happy. There's similar activity. Or you have the welfare activities. This is a growing activity. We have the community garden to grow clean, organic food, vegetable. The support from one community is very, very small, something like 700 $700. Okay, $700 is allow the community to think how to make a community garden or community vegetable, community green area. And this vegetable garden is a collective garden. People help each other to grow it, take care of it. And if you don't have the money, you can take any vegetable. Okay, so it's a very giving activity for the people, and it's quite popular. It's a food production kind of program and organic, no? You can have the children program. This is the children network, children saving, children activity about technology, how to make a survey of different things and so on. So the housing activities, housing project is open for this kind of human activity to be organized. And that's something so important. I personally feel this is more important, but this can only be possible when we able to secure housing. The secure housing, the secure physical housing activity lead to many more social space like this to be organized. And this is something totally lacking in the modern housing communities. Modern housing community is just a provision of shell, and there's no such activity. So people in the modern Asian or global society are living as individual. And you link only with the municipality or the media or the larger system. But you don't have a small system like this to provide you an integrated social space to help each other, to share the love among each other. And for health system particularly, if people are so close like that, you know what happened to your members. They even have a health group, a health care group, where they help each other on the basic health care. And they also link with the clinic or the hospital outside. So if you have such a system from the outside and the inside like this, you can take care of everybody. And any symptom, any sign that some member would have any kinds of problem, you can protect. Protecting is much better than solving the problem at the end, at the end stage. Yeah. And education, you can do it through this kind of organization. So this is what I think is important message to talk to the health communities. Yeah? If we talk about housing project, we are not only physical house, but we talk about collective land, we talk about community saving and fund, which function as a bank for the people. We talk about welfare activities, which is all kinds of welfare activity. We are talking about the network that is not one single community which is doing that, but link it into the whole city. And with that, you can make a political change. You can influence the city, because the city needs mass to talk to, yeah, in different issue, and you have collective management. So this is the activity that link into the political change of the system of the city, and it's integrated political, economic, social, physical, or even city planning, yeah, as a whole. Yeah. This is the sort of very general picture in many of the situation now, where the city and the people are sort of get together in several issues of the city. Yeah, this is just to show it's a little too slow. Now we have more than 107,000 families, and the repayment rate is now 97.5%. This is the Thai experience. And this poor urban development that it has been happened, it could reduce poverty, it could increase the income, and could make better health conditions for the people at the same time. And this is the ACA program in which I present before. I just want to show some picture. The concept is important. And we cannot say just, oh, that's Thailand, you can do it. But this is just trying to show that with the same concept, with a much fewer amount of money, you can make an intervention to Asia. This is the ACA program that happened in 200 cities. In 19 countries. Next, this is very short for the Asia part. you have only about $60,000 for the citywide upgrading. $60,000, very little for the citywide intervention, stir the whole city with this amount of money, including one housing project and 5, 6, 7 small upgrading projects, community network, community fund, collaboration with the cities. So each city can start with the mapping, like that. So start by seeing how many community we have and link those community into a network. And then you support the small upgrading, just a walkway, $3,000. But it could make the whole neighborhood so excited that we can solve the problem together like that. This is the banking where it's erosion happen all the time. So now they can stop it by community change, by this intervention. This is in Cambodia. And then it lead to a more difficult solution of housing. We support the process of making plan for housing in 146 cities in this ACA project. And these are some of the picture of those support. You can see that many of these housing must cost more than $1,000, because the $1,000 is sort of lead the game. The $40,000 that we support, it sort of open up negotiation. So people do a saving. They could get some support. This is Gopakan. The housing costs much more than $1,000 because we're able to link with the UNDP project. But the UNDP project alone never tried to do it. They have a lot of money and they want to spend money. Okay, but they do it in other thing, in other way. We said, if we have the money, $40,000, but it would go to this way, where people do it together. So the money match, it's a matching fund together with the people saving. And it's okay. Yeah? And they're happy because they can count this project into their stock of project. And it's a success project like that. Yeah. Cambodia, this is Mongolia, Nepal. Yeah, of course, we can have the architects to work with the people. So the key issue to let the people build a system, so make community people become architects as much as possible. Plan for yourself, not only physical, but system. Picture about Cambodia. I use a lot of old picture because I don't have the time. And the important thing is that all the project create new political space. And new political space is something important. It's not just social welfare, that you give somebody the thing they want to fulfill their hungry. Not only that, but projects create new political space for negotiation for the poor people who never have power to start building up their negotiation power and the belief that they can do things. They can be the one who lead the game. Not only as a follower to whatever government program, which would continue to be very much ignored, especially the poorer you are, the more you fall away from the government target. No, so women, like women, would have a role. In Afghanistan, you're able to link the men and the women to work together through the saving and the small project and the big project, and all lead to build a new partnership between a different group of people. And if we're able to make a partnership, it means we're able to make more a policy change, a structural change. Yeah? And that's very important. How small thing will lead into a bigger change. And every small thing that we intervene or support should also become small thing that lead to structural change in the people and the system as much as possible. And that's something I think is really important. And this only led to health. Health is not just a sort of welfare thing, but it needs a power chip, a new negotiation between the people who need them and the people who provide. Next, please. I think we need now. This is what we have for the presentation in Detroit. Just twist the issue from the last presentation I gave here into the health subject, but of course it relates to many other possibilities. So any question? from the group or anything you would like to ask, or you think there are more relationships you want to dialogue.
Thank you very much. Thank you, all of you.